Welcome to Back to Basics. To get business insight, you and your data engineering team build and manage data pipeline to extract, transform, and load data. ETL provides the foundation to your data analytics and machine learning applications. You can apply a series of business rules in ETL to clean and organize data to address business intelligence use cases, such as monthly reporting. Today, we will discuss modernizing ETL process with an event-driven serverless data pipeline you can build on AWS. Let's dive in. When you start building ETL data pipeline from ground up, you begin with provisioning infrastructure resources such as servers, networking, to get your ETL tools implemented, configured, and tested. This provisioning process could take weeks and months, depends on the complexity of your environment and ETL tools. Once deployed, you will spend time managing and maintaining ETL tools by ensuring servers are patched, applications are updated. I have experience patching and fixing to stabilize ETL tools so the overnight ETL batch job could continue. It's not fun. Once your ETL tools is deployed, you will need to configure it to automate ETL processes. For a batch job, you configure ETL processes to run when the data become available. A common method is running jobs on schedule. Because data loads vary, even a small batch job may run for different duration of times. This may result in a waste of paying idling resources between two job runs or a job failure due to an extra large load of data. Many of you have experience with this, and you may think, what if an ETL tool can easily scale and you only need to pay for the resources that's been utilized? What if your ETL tools is always available for business logic configuration and you have no underlying infrastructure to manage? Here it comes AWS Glue. Given there's a wide range of data integration use cases you can design ETL pipeline solutions for, we will discuss an implementation example that you can modernize and scale ETL pipeline using AWS Glue by building an event-driven serverless ETL data pipeline on AWS. A starting point with an ETL process is ingesting data. You need a scalable data store for the ingested data when building a scale ETL data pipeline. You can pick Amazon S3 as your serverless data pipeline and use it as the primary data store of all your data. By using Amazon Data Sync, SFTP application, or other techniques and applications, your document data arrive in a bucket on Amazon S3 service. To make your users easily and securely find and access data, the ingested data needs to be cataloged based on its schema. You can scale and automate this process, apply security access rules by using AWS Glue Data Catalog. To turn this ETL data pipeline to be event-driven so you avoid paying idling resources between the scheduled jobs, you would want to trigger the data processing upon the data arrival in S3 bucket. You can do this using AWS Lambda function invoked by Amazon S3 trigger to start an AWS Glue crawler that catalogs the data. You can program AWS Glue crawler to scan data in all kinds of repositories, including Amazon S3 and database services, classify it, extract schema information, and store the metadata automatically in the AWS Glue data catalog. To scale this event-driven ETL data pipeline, you would want to run jobs in parallel when required. You can use Amazon SQS to manage large volume of Amazon S3 triggered invocations in the event of varied data loads arriving simultaneously. When AWS Glue crawler is finished storing metadata in the AWS Glue data catalog, you invoke a second Lambda function using an Amazon Event Bridge event rules so AWS Glue catalog can be used to guide ETL operations. AWS Lambda function starts an AWS Glue ETL job to process and output data into another Amazon's S3 bucket. For example, you may want to use AWS Glue ETL job to convert the data to a desirable data format, such as Apache Parquet format. You may also modify the ETL job to achieve other objectives, like more granular partitioning, compression, or enriching of the data. To make this ETL pipeline more scalable, you would want to automate monitoring and notification process. As soon as the ETL job finishes, another event bridge rule sends you an email notification using an Amazon Simple Notification Service SNS topic. This notification indicates that your data was successfully processed. There you have an event-driven, scalable, and highly automated ETL data pipeline that you have no servers or underlying infrastructure to manage. In this episode, we explored an implementation design of building an event-driven serverless data pipeline on AWS. I have used this design more than once. Now we can use it too. Check out the links below for more details. See you next time.